It's been 1 year since we've had the Bleach Hell chapter, which I think synonymously everybody agreed that was an amazing chapter. And the one question that everybody wanted to know is there going to be more, considering on how it ended? And that's what we're going to be discussing today. But buckle up, because we might have an answer. So let's get into it. Now, if you guys aren't aware, a year ago we had a sequel to the Bleach manga giving us the Hell chapter, bringing us into the concept of Hell, talking about Unohana, Ukitake, Yamamoto, whether, you know, they're going to be in Hell or not, and turns out that they are, and giving us a dark secret about the Hell butterflies themselves, bringing back characters such as Zylopro Granz, and also giving us a little bit of Kazui and Ichiga and what their roles are, kind of, but not kind of at the same time, because it's good that, unlike the Boruto Next Generations, we actually have Ichigo still as our main character. So far, so good. And I hope Kubo potentially keeps it that way. So what is this video all about? Is the Hellverse coming back? And obviously, from my predictions, I think it will, because it makes sense from a business mindset, and also for other things such as BBS content to be added, as well as more stuff later on down the road if the Bleach anime succeeds. Now, if you're not aware of, for the past 2 years, there's been a fan club called The Club Outside, where answers and questions are given. And we've had many interesting answers from questions being given. Now, you have to take into consideration that many of what Kubo has said has actually come into fruition to some sort. And I mean, the site in and of itself has garnered a big following with a large amount of followers and subscribers. So let's read into this answer that we're given, and let's elaborate just a little bit more into it and why it's important. Somebody asked the question of, I just read the whole thing in regarding to the one shot. I've just read the whole thing and I got goosebumps because I haven't had this for such a long time. I'm sure that this is just a one shot, but is there going to be a sequel? I'd love to read the rest. Everybody has been asking this question since the one shot came out, and it's very interesting that it's only just been kind of publicly shown now, because Kubo again gets to pick and choose these questions to answer. So of course, if you're not going to answer a question like this, you're obviously going to be avoiding it or not wanting to talk about it or not give sort of a negative answer in that regard. Just business wise and psychologically wise, you would not do that. But I'm glad that somebody's question finally got through. So what is the answer? So Kubo answers, I'm not good at drawing when I'm told to draw, so I will think about it when I stop being told to draw. There is so many interesting things along with this answer and why it's important. One, if you are first reading this at first glance, you'll be like, cool, oh my god, like, you know, if he wants to draw it, he will draw it. And Kubo's always said that, along with many other things, that, you know, he does things on his own time. And this has been shown to us through many other different works. But that in and of itself is not really the most interesting part about this answer. It's the fact that he's not good at drawing when he is told to draw. So this tells me straight away that Shueisha themselves are asking Kubo to create the sequel and to continue the sequel. Now, I think it's in no shadow of a doubt in my mind that the Hell chapter in and of itself did amazingly. And I think with Chainsaw Man Part 2 coming back and the reception that that's had, and with One Piece potentially ending in 3 to 5 years, Jump, I feel, is going to be needing a series that is not so much carry it, but give it some value for essentially people to carry on, like reading and purchasing the magazine. And this has clearly been very apparent since the Hellverse chapter. Keep calling it Hellverse. Can we still call it Hellverse? So yeah, it seems like Kubo doesn't want to draw it because he's being forced to, or being told to in a sense, and he doesn't feel like that's right to draw something for the sake of drawing it because he's being told to, but he does have a desire to draw when he feels like it. And it's been the same with Burn the Witch season 2, when Burn the Witch, you know, ended, and then the editorial department put season 2 at the end when he didn't actually agree to do season 2 at any point in time, though he did have plans to. And that's the most interesting thing about it, is that even though he said to the editorial department, I'm not doing this yet, I'll do it when I'm ready, they still went ahead and put season 2 with some drafts that Kubo obviously gave. The fact that these drafts have been made and they're available, and some, you know, it's already been pre-planned, is a good indication to show you that obviously Kubo, the way he wrote Burn the Witch and its ending, and especially with the Bleach Hell chapter and how that ended, it clearly opened up a lot of doors. It was very, like, it wasn't essentially a chapter which you would feel good about it just being a single one shot. It clearly had a lot more to offer, and Kubo obviously gave us a lot more to work off of, essentially. Especially with that ending with Kazui and, you know, the editorial notes at the bottom saying, you know, it was going to continue, blah, 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 blah. It seems that we have word from the horse's mouth himself, and it just validates the fact that this is going to be essentially happening at some point. And why does this make sense from a business standpoint? And when do I think it's going to be happening? Well, of course, I think Burn the Witch 2, or Season 2, if we really want to call that, is going to be top priority. I think he has most of the content done for that, if not all of it. And, you know, it will be released at some point. Bear in mind that in the Club Kubo newsletter that you get every week after, I believe at the start of this year in 2022, it was said by one of the editorials of the website that there was going to be Burn the Witch news this year. And considering we are in, what is it, August now? Yeah, we're in August. Tells me that there is going to be an announcement at Jump Festa. That's my guess. And I think we're going to get a lot of Burn the Witch next year. I think the focus at the moment is the Bleach anime, and Kubo is busy working on the anime, especially extra scenes, such as, for example, Unohana's movement in the Bankai, and giving a lot of extra details to the animation staff. This has been said. If you watch the Viz interview, he's said this clear as day. So there's no shadow of a doubt that that has been his priority. Once I believe they've had enough of that extra detail and the concept arts that Kubo wants to send over, I think Burn the Witch, if it hasn't already been done, is going to be then prioritized into the magazine alongside with the anime's release to help again with some nice little boost of sales, so to say. So I think that definitely makes sense. So whether Kubo wants to go the direction of seasonals with Burn the Witch, or just do a continuous long-running series of manga like, you know, he previously did with Bleach and many manga could do in Jump, then again we'll have to see if there's going to be a season 3 or season 4, or if it's just going to stay as it is and just continue on for as long as Kubo wants to. But again, Kubo is in a position where he gets to do things at his own time, and it shows the amount of quality that comes out of it when Kubo is in full control without the deadlines. And I guess to some sort of extent as well, also Chainsaw Man Season 2 as well, you can definitely see a bit of a pace difference. And again, it doesn't matter which way you translate it or what translation website you use, it's still one and the same. He will think about it when he's not being pressured to, or when he's not being asked to. And that's what's important, is the fact that he's even considering it, the fact that he may even have plans, and the fact of, I don't think he wants to go the same route that he did before and having all those health issues. So I think that this is the best. So again, I think 2023 is going to be maybe the year of Burn the Witch. We're going to have a lot of Bleach content involved, and then I think around about the age of 2024 and then 2025, we'll probably get more Bleach Hellverse content. And that is pretty huge, because again, if the anime does well, again, they can dabble with the light novels, which I think is important, because the light novels kind of are synonymous a little bit with the Thousand Year Blood War arc, especially with, you know, the aftermath of that, about, you know, Ichibe and the Iran cars, and if they're going to include that into the anime is another question in and of itself that we'll probably find out later next year, depending on what kind of added content we get in. But again, they're important factors to have in. Are they going to be movies? Are they going to be OVAs? Or are they just going to go the route of, you know, the Can't Fear Your Own World novels? Are they going to be adaptated? I think they will be. I think if Jujutsu Kaisen film Zero has proven anything, is that you don't potentially need a main character to carry a series, so to say. So I'm excited. I think that this is a big thing. I think this is huge. And I think, again, for the stability of Bleach Brave Souls, for the stability of continuously anime content, I think that this is huge. And I think it makes perfect market sense. I think Kubo's down for it. If anything, it's been proven that he's down for it. And the fact that Shueisha is asking him to draw is a huge piece of information that we can all kind of be rest assured that eventually Kubo will sit down and give us some more amazing content. And again, the anime has a lot going for it as well, especially within the 10-year time skip that they can dabble in as well, to give some little buffer time that I think Kubo has probably give a lot of information in regards to that as well. And thinking about it now, the compositor for the Bleach Thousand Year Blood War anime is more on the side of Hiromitsu, I believe, is one of the main reasons of why they hired that person, is because they're mostly used to adapting novels. So again, I was very questionable on whether they were going to do the manga correctly, because they haven't really got a portfolio of adaptating manga. But maybe this is why they hired someone that is more used to doing novel adaptations. Maybe because when you haven't got pictures and you've just got words, they are able to bring out something in detail for an anime adaptation. But that's just my two cents on that. So, is the Thousand Year Blood War arc going to be continuing into the Hell arc? I think this is a very strong yes. And I think we can all get excited for that. So, tell me what you guys think in the comment section down below. If you haven't subscribed already, do subscribe. And of course, hit that like button because it really helps out. Genuinely, it does. That being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Being handsome, and as always, people, peace out.